एम वर लेफ्ट. तो इन दिस क्लास वी विल बी स्टार्टिंग फ्रॉम प्रेडेटर्स द पैरासाइट्स. इन प्रेडेटर्स लेट सी व्हाट आर द प्रेडेटर्स. प्रेडेटर्स आर फ्री लिविंग ऑर्गेनिजम्स थ्रू आउट द लाइफ एंड यूजुअली लार्जर इन साइज and require more than one for developing free living adults. Means okay, that if one insect is there which is larger in shape and once it kill its prey, it will be start living freely. Means they will be not dependent on that prey. Okay, but in parasites they dependent on their host and they kill their host and maybe it requires more host. Okay, and one more term is there, parasitoids. Parasitoids is a special kind of parasite which is often about the same size as its host. Means predators were larger than their prey but the parasitoids were of the same size as its host are there. It kills its host and required only one host for developing into free living adult. Over here the parasitoids required only and only one host. Okay, but the predators require more than one prey. So difference between the parasitoids and predators is usually asked in the exams ki which one is the larger in size and which one require more prey. So just mind it in your notes and make it highlight over the predators and parasitoids. And after that we are having some snails, fish, duck and geese. These are over here which also used to control the weeds. For insects we have already discussed biological agents. In insects we have already discussed for Opuntia weed, for Lantana camara, for Parthenium, and you have to learn all the insects like Opuntia weed and cactoblasts, Dactylopicus and cactoblastic. And cactoblastic is a type of cactus moth. Okay, this also asked in exam ki cactoblastic which kind of organism the cactoblastis is. And Dactylopicus is a Now we are having Lantana camara. In Lantana camara, we have studied three: the Crocodisma, Crocidosima, and the second one is Agromyza. Over here, you have to write the species name is Lantana and Agromyza. Lantini, it's Lantanae, Lantini, and the third one is the Thekla. For Lantana, we are having three: Crocidosima, Lantana, Agrozyma, Lantini, and the third one is the Thekla Echion or Brazochi. Okay, these three insects then are used against the Lantana camara. And Thekla is a butterfly. Agromyza is seed fly.
seed fly, and Crocidocyma lantana is also one moth. Okay, I think Dactylopicus is a flea beetle. I will confirm. I'm forgetting over here. Dactylopicus is scale insects. Okay, I was forgetting. It should be a scale insect. Okay, so this you have to learn. Ki, whether it may be asked you to the scientific name, ki which insects is used, or they can also ask Dactylopicus is the kind of microorganism, its kind of organism. It may be cactus moth, the scale insect, or and they can ask it about the butterfly, and none of these means options will be like this. Okay, and for the Parthenium, the most important one, the Zygogramma. Zygogramma Bicolorata. Okay, and it is the beetle. Which kind of insect is it? It is a beetle, and this beetle is brought from the Mexico, and that's why it is known as the Mexico beetle. And in for Parthenium, first one is the Zygogramma Bicolorata, and the second one is the Epiblema Istriuniana, which is a gall insect. Okay, which is a gall insect. Then we are having Icornia crassifers for the water hyacinth. For water hyacinth, and we are having the larva of Neocertina. Okay, this you can call it as Neocertina bruci. The species name is bruci, and it is also an insect found in the Australia. Okay, then we are having the Cuscuta. For Cuscuta, we are using Ismicronyx. Cuscuti. Ismicronyx Cuscuti. For Cuscuta, we are using this. Then we are having the Salvinia molesta. For this, we are using a grasshopper. And its name is Poilinia acuminata. Acuminata. Okay. So, Salvinia and Poilinia means is accordingly we can learn nia is there. Okay, and then we are having in a Altonanthera, which is also known as alligator weed. Against this weed, we are using Azacides hygrophila. Azacides hygrophila. Okay, and these are the important ones. There are some many, we are there, but we don't have to focus on this. These are the important ones. Okay. Then we are having some duck and geese also, which have been experimented for the weed control in the rice culture and the cotton, strawberries, mint, and some other crops. Means the duck and geese, these two, you are used against the weed control in rice, cotton, strawberries, mint, and other crops. Okay. And the first thing of the grass weeds, and the geese for seedling of the of grass weeds. Then we are having the fish, and we use the fish if such as common carp, which is known as common carp, or Chinese carp, or white emmer for aquatic weeds. And we are having snails also. Having snails also, like Marisha, Marisha for the submerged weeds and algae. Okay. And there are some deleterious rhizobacteria also, but these are not ours in the exam, so we are not focusing on that. But and so many bio herbicides I have already told, who learned it by the heart. Okay. Like Divine, Polego, Velgo, ABS, and cast is there. Now we have to look after the biological weed control. What are the bioagents? If someone is asking ki what is the definition of the biological agents or the bioagents, to means the utilization of the natural living organism, and utilization of natural living organism for the control of the weed, it is known as bioagents. And the bioagents are especially of two types, a specific one and the non-specific. A specific one attacks only one or two specific weeds. Okay, only one or two specific, but the non-specific, it can feed on variety of vegetation. The difference between specific bioagents and the non-specific bioagents, in a specific they can feed or they can attack only one or the two specific weed, but in a non-specific they feed upon a variety of vegetation. And we have to focus on the quality of the bioagents. Means we can't use any of the bioagents against any weed. Okay, but there should be some characteristic, some quality should be present in the bioagents, then only we can use as a bioagents. Like the first one is the host specificity. Okay, means it should be host specific. Means in some organism can completely control one species, that should be the host specificity. It should be free from natural enemies. Means no enemies of that bioagent should be present in that locality. Should not feed on other useful plants. Okay, of course. It should not feed on other useful plants. Of course, because if it feeds on the our useful plant, then and we will be in loss. Okay, then the fourth point is then adaptability to the new environment. That bioagent should be adaptable. Well, should be adaptable to the new environment. Otherwise, if it is not then able to adapt in the new environment, then it will not completely control that weed. Then we are having the fifth point is the efficient reproductive capacity. Efficient reproductive capacity. Of course, not organic. We are adding one agent into a new environment, and if it is not able to reproduce, and it reproduce after reproduction, and the control of that weed can be increased. Okay, then we are having 6 point, fast damaging ability. It should damage the weed very rapid manner, in a rapid manner, and able to seeking out the host and kill the last but not the least, the seventh one, kill the weed or at least prevent its reproductive in some direct or indirect way. Means the weed can be controlled in direct or indirect way. This should be the main aim. Now we are having the what is should be the objective of biological control. Well, the biological control objective is not the eradication. Is the eradication removal of any kind of species, but though in biological agent we are not eradicating anything, but we reduce, means the reduction and regulation is there. Reduction and regulation of weed population. Okay, this should be the, this is the main aim or the main objective of the biological control. All that in it's not eradicating, but it's reduces, and the regulation of weed population below the level of economic injury. Means we are not economically in loss. Okay, and with that it control the weed population. And the merits, what are the merits, what are the advantages of the biological method of control is this: it is relatively cheap, or this is the long lasting, because chemical control is not long lasting effect, but in biological control it's a long lasting, because we are using the bio agents in those having the efficient. Okay, and last one is the least harm to environment and the non-target and organisms, and this is also the quality that then it should not or feed on other useful crop or the plant, and this should be its least harm to environment and the non-target and organisms. Okay, now we are having the chemical method. In chemical method you have to learn something like which was the earliest attempt in India using the chemical method. Chemical means we are using any chemical method means we are using any chemical compounds against the weed then it is known as chemical method. And the first attack in India was against the Imperata cylindrica Imperata cylindrica or कार्थमस ऑक्सीकेंथ. कार्थमस इट्स अ वाइल्ड सैप फ्लावर फ्लावर विच वॉज इन 1937 इन द पंजाब. Okay, the earliest attempt in India was made to control the weed by herbicide in 1937 in Punjab, which weed Carthamus oxycantha, and which chemicals we are using? Sodium arsenite. Okay, then we are having the credit for introducing 2,4-D as herbicide goes to Mart and Michael. Means 2,4-D, Mart and Michael, scientist belongs from USA in 1944D for the tested in for six. These scientists in 1944D he was used by these two scientists. Yeah, for time I'm tested was done in 1946 and name the quad which introduced the chemical concept in weed control whole in India was in tea plantation. Okay, this paraquat which introduced chemical concept in weed control particularly in the tea plantation, and the maximum herbicide is used in tea and coffee because only they use herbicide. Maximum herbicide are used in India, it is used in tea and coffee. Okay. Now we have to focus on different methods of the chemical compounds. Okay. The first one is the selective herbicide, the second one is the non-selective herbicide, the third one is soil treatments, and one soil fumigation. Now we
have... Hello. You are disconnected.
Hello.
Yes, ma'am.
Hello. Actually, I think there was a network problem.
No problem, ma'am. You can share your screen.
Okay. Okay.
Hello, ma'am. Your voice is breaking. Hello. Hello. Hello, ma'am. Hello, ma'am. Your voice is breaking. You just once again connect, ma'am.
Hello.
Hello.
Is it audible?
Yeah, it's very much audible. No.
Okay. the chemical control, different types of chemical control. Hello.
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 Ah, ma'am, you can continue.
Is it audible now?
Okay. Yes, ma'am, it is audible, but it's actually breaking. Your voice is breaking. You just once again try.
I have connected.
Yes, hello.
Okay, I'm trying.
Now it's okay only, ma'am. You just continue with it.
Okay, it's okay now?
Yeah, it's okay.
Okay. The different types of chemical method we will be discussing in when we will be starting the herbicide, the different types of herbicide, then at that time I will be discussing, because again over there I have to take this. Okay, now the fifth one is the biochemical method, and in biochemical method we are having two types, or we can use the allelopathy and the allelochemicals, and the second one is the herbicide resistant crops. So first we will be look into the allelopathy and allelochemicals. So first we have to see what is the allelopathy. So allelopathy is derived from a Greek word. Okay, this allelopathy is derived from a Greek word, and that Greek word is allelon, or you can say allelo. Okay, and the meaning of this allelon or allelo is the mutual or each other, and this pathos, the second word is allelopathy from the two Greek word allelon or allelo, and the second one is the pathos, or you can say patho, and the meaning of this is suffering or to suffer. Okay, so means the allelopathy is a Greek word, and this can be asked in any of the exam ki the derivation of allelopathy is from the Greek word, Latin word, Anglo-Saxon word, and or the none of these or all of these, like this the option will be there. And the two word are allelion or allelo, and the second word the pathos or the patho. Allelion means mutual or each other, and the pathos means suffering or to suffer. And this term allelopathy was coined in 1937 by the scientist Hans Molist. Okay, you have to learn this name. It is the name of one scientist. In H. Molist also you can say. And then in 1977, and allelopathy is synonymous with the toxic hypothesis of plant interaction. I don't think so ki for competitive exams so it is important, just leave it. But over here I'm just telling ki in 1977, and the scientist Harper has derived the synonyms of allelopathy with toxic hypothesis of plant interaction. Okay, so in 1977 Harper has used the allelopathy synonyms with the toxic hypothesis of plant interaction. And later the allelopathy have been in classified or divided with on the basis of three factors. Okay, means there are different types of allelopathy, the first, second and the third. Three types, on that basis it get classified, and on the basis of the species is this is allelo. Allelopathy, and the second one is the auto allelopathy. When in alloallelopathy, he inter specific chemical coaction is there. Means within. Inter means within. With one species to other species. To remember the difference between the inter and intra, when in your college or the school, you are having the competition between in the students of your own college, then at that time it is known as intra. Okay, the competition over there is in between your the students of your college or university or only, then it is known as an intra specific competition or like this a intra competition is there. But when you are having the competition with the other college or the university students, then it is known as inter. Okay, inter competition. So when there is the competition or the chemical coagulation interaction and between the inter specific means other species, then it is known as interspecific chemical coaction, and autoallelopathy means intraspecific chemical coaction. And then we are having the second type, we are having the true allelopathy and the functional allelopathy. When the chemicals released directly are toxic, matlab true who ki when any chemical release from the plant leaves or any part of the plant and are directly toxic, okay, are directly toxic, then it is known as true allelopathy. And when the chemicals modify macroorganisms and then they become the toxic, it is known as functional allelopathy. Then we are having concurrent allelopathy and residual allelopathy. When instantaneous direct effect of release of toxic means in concurrent means within short period of time means the chemical is released and it acts upon the other crop and it become visible, their effect is visible and it affects are instantaneous, then it is known as concurrent or direct allelopathy. And the residual effect obtained in succession from decaying residues, leaf, litter, stems, roots, then it is known as residual allelopathy. This is known as direct or the live plant effect. Means the we don't have to wait to decomposition of that plant part. And in residual is known as is also known as dead plant effect, because the decaying residues, leaf litter, stems, and the other parts of the plant after decomposition, it becomes effective in showing the allelopathy effect. Okay, so there are three bases. The first one, this on the basis of the species interaction, we are having alloallelopathy or autoallelopathy. Auto means within itself. Okay, means auto means khud se. When wheat is having competition with other wheat plant, then it is known as autoallelopathy. But allo allelopathy, when the means the wheat is having competition with the rice, means the species get differ, then it is known as interspecific chemical coaction. Then on the basis of the release, the components released, is on that basis the true types are there, true allelopathy and the functional allelopathy. Over here it should be double L, allelopathy. If when any chemical release and they are not modified but they directly are toxic, then it is known as true allelopathy. And functional allelopathy, the modified by the microorganism. Okay, then we are having concurrent, means the live plant effect is there, and in residual dead plant effect is there. Over here you just have to remember this, not the example so much, but the types, means these terms, or alloallelopathy, autoallelopathy, true allelopathy, functional, concurrent and residual. What is the difference between all these is allelopathy. Then we are the second type, we are having herbicide resistant crops. Okay, so in herbicide, the most recent one, because the HTTD cotton, this is very much in the news in 2020 June, because the Maharashtra and the South Indian farmers are using HTTD cotton. And over here, HT means herbicide tolerant, and T means Bacillus and thuringiensis bacteria, because this BT is used against insect. Okay, BT is used against the insect, but HT is used against the herbicide, because this cotton plant we can't use glyphosate herbicide directly, because it reduces the quality of the cotton, and that's why by using the biotechnology we have discovered. But this HTBT cotton and is not approved one, but then also the farmers are using in this seed. Okay, because of that, this is and because of that, and this HTBT cotton is very much in the news. Okay, BTE means Bacillus thuringiensis. It contains the protein to help the crop resist pest attack. And HTBT cotton helps the plant withstand the effects of herbicide. They are sprayed to kill the weeds on the plant, beside and resisting pest attack. Means they are useful for resisting the pest attack also, and they can withstand the effect of herbicide also. And this is also so reduce the cost of production, because and the chemical use, means the herbicide used are more economically than the labor, means the hand weeding or like this, because hand weeding is expensive and it required labor also, laborious method. Okay, then we are having integrated weed management method. And in integrated weed management, we are using the physical one, the chemical one, the mechanical one, and the biological method also. Okay, and there are some integrated weed management practices for different crops also, which we have to follow. Okay, because otherwise it will be be very much costly for us to use only one method. Okay. They are telling for different the major crop, the rice and wheat. For that is the same. Hello. For rice, we have to do the summer plowing. Okay. Then we have to use the stale seed bed also. And we have to use the cropping system also. We should not go for monocropping, because if we are going for monocropping again and again, we should not go for the monocropping, but we should go for double cropping. Okay, like after rice, we have to take wheat. Okay, then we have to the most important one, and in rice, the clot. This is the herbicide which can be mostly used, and the trade name of this is Machet. Okay, butaclor for 1 kg AI per hectare. This we will be discussing later, but just learn it after learning, because it can be asked directly in the exam. And this butaclor is used as the pre-emergence herbicide. This also we will be discussing later, what is the pre-emergence. Then we are having Anilo guard, which is also known as Anilofos, which is used again the grasses we present in the rice. And the second one is 2,4-D is also used, but this 2,4-D is used against the broad leaved weed. Okay. Then we have to do hand weeding at 30 days after sowing, and in crop rotation, and we have to take the rice first in upland and then in lowland. And we can use the biological control also. We can have the biological control also. Okay. So these were for the rice. And for wheat, let's see. We have to do 2 hand weeding. Okay. The first at 20 to 25 days after sowing, and the first one is this, and the second one we have to do after 2 weeks. Okay, interval. Then we have to take higher seed rate, and if we are taking higher seed rate, then this type of method it is? It is cultural method. And because if we take the high rate, it decreases Avena Fatua means wild. Then we are having the changing the planting time also, and the changing planting time is also cultural method. Then we have to use the competitive cultivar. This is also the cultural one. And then we have to do the crisscross sown at 20
2.5 सेंटीमीटर स्पेसिंग, 22.5 सेंटीमीटर स्पेसिंग पे क्रिस क्रॉस और सोइंग करना चाहिए. ओके, तो जस्ट रिमेम्बर फॉर दीज फॉर राइस एंड वीट, द इंटीग्रेटेड वीट मैनेजमेंट मींस दैट इज सिंपली आई हैव आई वांट टू टेल यू इन दिस कि वी आर नॉट यूजिंग ओनली द केमिकल्स. एंड हाँ, इन वीट we have to know the sulfuron, all the sulfuron types of this are there here, which is used mostly in the weed. Okay, and we can use biological method also, and we have to go for the hand weeding. And okay, physical or mechanical is the same, which should be the cultural. Well, cultural method means we can change the time of sowing, we can use the higher seed rate, we should use the competitive cultivars, and the spacing also we can change. This is also in the cultural. Okay. So all these sevens means integrated weed management we have seen, then we biochemical method we have seen in this allelopathy and herbicide resistant crops are there. In allelopathy, I have told you who this key allelopathy is derived from the Greek word, and herbicide resistant crops are there means biotechnology. The biotechnology we are using these crops, and the most recent one which is present in this news is HTBT cotton. Then we are having chemical method. This we will be discussing in detail when we will start the herbicide. Just remember the fourth one is the chemical method. We are having biological method, and in biological method so many things means bio herbicide, or this is also as when bio herbicides are there which we have discussed, and when in the fungus, the fungus microorganism is used as the bioherbicide, then it is also known as mycoherbicides. Okay, this one term should be remembered. When a microorganism like fungus is used against any weed control, then it is known as mycoherbicide. The parasites we are already discussed. What are the parasites? Usually, and one parasitoids are there, which is a kind of the parasites also. Which one is bigger, the parasite or the predators? The predators are bigger in size, is a snail, and all these things we have discussed. Then we have discussed the cultural, or you can also say it the ecological method. In this we are having so many things. Then we are having physical method, and in this also these can be asked draining and chaining is used against which type of weeds, what is soil solarization, where the chilling process is used, what is difference between the burning and flaming, what is moving, and this one we have for cutting, what is difference between the moving and the cutting. In hand weeding and hand hoeing is used against which type of weed. So all these methods of the weed control are asked in the exams. What is the meaning of eradication, and what is the difference between control and management, what are the preventive measures of this. Okay, and questions completed, the preventive biological chemical. Okay, so all these questions will be asked in competitive exam. Superficially we have to see this. Now we have to see the history. Okay, some dates are also asked in the exams, so we have to see that thing. The people started cultivation and used to remove weeds by hand. Mean hand weeding is started since 10,000 BC before Christ, and then in 6,000 BC the people started to use the primitive hand tool, means like hand hoe or like a different and hand tools are hand hoe or any time means any type of tools are started in 6,000 BC. Then we are in 1,000 BC, we are having the animal drawn on implements, means the tools which can and be drawn by the animal, so that the weed control is easier, become easier, means the men, if men will be drawing that implement, then it required so much energy, but if animal can draw, all the men labor can be reduced, and animal drawn implement like harrow have been started over there. Then in since 1920 he improved animal drawn implements like plow, cultivators, blade hoe, rotary like tractor drawn plows, cultivator, blade, disc have been put into use for the tillage and the weed control. Means from the 1920 the tractor drawn implements were also started. Okay, and different types of improved animal drawn implements have been in established. Then in 1880 to the mid of the 1940, can be using the salts of the inorganic acids or inorganic compounds exercised mainly in non-cropped area. Over here, you have to see the In non-cropped area, salts of acids or salts of inorganic compounds were started. Means the chemical method started from 1880 to the mid of the 1940. Then in 1930, biological control of weed was conceptualized. In 1930, the people understand about the biological control of weed. In 1947, chemical control using organic herbicide. Means before that, in 1880 to 1940, we are using only inorganic compounds or the salts. But from 1947, we started organic compounds like 2,4-D, MCPA, ANO. Okay, in 1940, organic compounds have been started. Then in 1952, the first coordinated weed control scheme on wheat, rice and sugarcane have been started in 11 states by ICAR. Okay, so in 1952, coordinated weed control scheme on wheat, rice and sugarcane in 11 states has been started by ICAR. Okay, coordinated weed control scheme. Then in 1960 the phenomenon of allelopathy was defined by Mollist in 1937, this I have told you in that. But research initiated towards evaluation and detection of the allelopathy across the weed and the crop. Okay, but allelopathy interaction between weed and crops research has been initiated towards evaluation and detection. Okay, and the concept of integrated weed management have been started since 1970. IWM, integrated weed management, IWM has been started from 1970. Then in 1978, in All India Coordinated Projects on Weed Control by ICAR is collaboration with US Department of Agriculture. Okay, mean in 1978, All India Coordinated Research Project on Weed Control, which was started by ICAR, are in collaboration. Kiske saath milke tha? USDA, United State Department of Agriculture. All India Coordinated Research Project on the Weed Control has been started by the ICAR, and initially six center were there for 6 years. Okay. 78 to 84, but after that 7 more centers have been added in that in the second phase. In first phase we are having only 6 center, but in second phase 7 more centers have been in added, and then again 9 more centers have been added in the third phase. Okay, and first six center was for 6 years, 78 to 84. But after that, in second phase, 82 to 83, for 5 years, the 7 more four centers were initiated. Then in 9 centers in 1985 to 86, again for the 5 years, means the second phase was for the 5 years, the third phase was for 5 years, but the first phase, the 6 center, is for 6 years. Okay, and the total center is equal to 6 plus 7 plus 9. Is equals to 22. So, and in this, the headquarter is also there, which is there in the Jabalpur. Okay, then this was happened in 1978. In 1986, National Research Center for Weed Science, National Research Center for Weed Science, approved and came into existence on 22 April 1986, and headquarters is there in the Jabalpur. Okay, and then in 2009, this National Research Center for Weed Science is upgraded. Okay, and this upgraded into Directorate of Weed Science Research. Okay, so this is very important. When was the coordinated scheme in weed control scheme on wheat, rice and sugar cane have been started in 1952, who in 1978 all coordinated product in collaboration with USDA has been started, and there were 3 phases, first phase, second phase and third phase. First phase was for 6 years in the 6 centers, and the second phase was for 5 years in 7 centers, and then again third phase is for 5 years in the 9 centers. Okay, and in In 1986, National Research Center for the wheat science have been improved and came into existence on 22nd April 1986. But this National Research Center for the Wheat Science is upgraded to the Directorate of Wheat Science Research. Okay, so these three, four are very important dates which you have to learn. Okay, and this also be 1970. This integrated weed management is started, and biological one is for 1930. Biological weed control were there in the 1930. Okay, just we are moving further.
Now we are having some types of dormancy.
Okay, which are very much asked in the exam, different types of dormancy. Okay, first, what is the definition of dormancy? When a seed is considered a dormant, if it does not germinate, okay, then the seed is not able to germinate, then it is known as dormant seed, or the process is known as the dormant means in the seed goes to sleep. Okay, and when the conditions are normally favorable for germination and the growth of that species. Okay, and you can also say that the dormancy is a state of suspended development of a seed or vegetative propagating structure. Okay, and dormancy is dispersed through time and is especially critical for the annual wheat. This is very important question ki dormancy is very important for annual weeds as against the perennial, because all in perennial we are having the vegetative propagation also. Oh, and but the annual seeds are only get multiplied through the seed production. Isiliye, through time is especially critical for the annual weeds. Okay, now we are having one more term. Quiescent phase. Okay, when the live seed in which none of the germination events are taking place, usually low oil content, are said to be quiescent. Means we don't have to get confused with the and the quiescent term, because in dormancy the favorable condition is there, but then also because in dormancy we are having the and also it germinate. Okay, but in quiescent food we are not having the favorable condition, but in which term? In the term of the low moisture. When we are having the low moisture, or and because of that the seed is not able to germinate, that then that is known as the quiescent. Okay, now there are three types of dormancy which you have to learn. The first one is the primary dormancy or natural innate, or you can say inherent. Over here, you have to focus means how you have to learn when natural or inherent means the natural.
And Harper used one term in 1927. He said that, or he described all the dormancy with modifying famous quotation. Okay, and there he said ki some seeds are dormant. Okay. Means when the seeds are born dormant, means the primary dormancy or the natural. Matlab, it's naturally, it is born dormant. But second one, some acquire dormant means the secondary dormancy, or you can and say it, the induced dormancy. It get induced into that seed. And then the last but not the least is the tertiary dormancy, which is also known as or you can say in forced dormancy. Okay, it's not tertiary, you can say in forced dormancy means have dormancy thrust upon them, means we enforced dormancy in the seed because of any process is thrust upon them. Okay, so some seeds are born dormant means the primary or the natural or innate or inherent, these all are same. The second one is the secondary dormancy or the induced one, when some acquired the dormancy. And the third one is the enforced dormancy, means some have dormancy thrust upon them. Okay. And in this, you just have to know that the primary dormancy is also of two types, exogenous dormancy and endogenous dormancy. Means further you don't have to go in depth, because only the types of dormancy is asked. The primary dormancy is of two types or three types, like this question will be asked. And exogenous is the type of which dormancy, so the answer should be the primary dormancy, like this. Over here you can see one seed is there, seed maturation is there. After seed get matured, and if it gets into the dormant phase, means the non-dormant seed are there, so the seed germinate. Okay. Okay, seed germination is there. Seed maturation is there, then we are harvesting, and naturally it is under the non-dormant seed and it gets germination. But when it goes, means the non-dormant seed induce something and the germination get inherits, that is known as the secondary dormancy. And when the seed maturation to the non-dormant seed, the process is in are there, the primary dormancy is present in between them. Okay, means the three processes are there, the seed maturation, then non-dormant seed and germination. So secondary dormancy is induced at, means after the non-dormant seeds, some factors are there, germination factors are there, which inhibit the germination process. But when seed maturation is there and dormancy induction factors are there here, and it does not come into the non-dormant phase, then that is known as the primary dormancy. Then we have between these two, primary and secondary, we have to apply dormancy breaking factors. Okay.
just understand the definition which you have to understand. In primary dormancy, it is the failure of fresh seed to germinate it even under the favorable weather condition. It is genetic in nature and it is most common dormancy in nature. It includes the condition that exists within the seed to prevent germination when the seed matures on the mature plant and immediately afterward. Means seed is over there and after the maturation, and it takes some time to be in the germination process. That is known as, but in secondary or the induced one, it develops in the seed after they are removed from the mother plant and subjected to adverse environment condition. When it removed from the mother plant and then it's subjected to the adverse environment, to the sudden physiological changes in the non-dormant seed. Over here, the secondary is induced in the non-dormant seed. It under the influence of the environmental conditions such as increase in the soil temperature, increase the CO2 concentration or the low oxygen pressure or the water logging, then at that time it induces the dormancy in the seed. Okay, but the info is due to the placement of the weed seed deeper than the 5 cm. Means due to the position. Over here it should be enforced only. The deeper, resulting usually from the tillage of the field, and the seeds of many seeds required exposure to the light for germination. Okay, at time we are having the most dormancy. So enforced dormancy is due to the presence in the deeper layer, but innate means the primary one is due to genetic factor or and like the hard seed coat or impermeable to the soil moisture like this. And the induced dormancy is due to the imbalance of oxygen and CO2 or the water logging condition. And the secondary induced one or the secondary one is the same one. Okay. Now we are having this can means you can learn in seed production technology also. Over here, so explaining it. I think it's hello,
ma'am.
Actually, I think I have exceeded the time. Okay, so I will be discussing in the later class. Okay.
Yes.
The ways to break dormancy of the seed, I will be, and then germination process also, I will be discussing in the next class. Thank you, class.
Thank you, ma'am. Ma'am, actually, my Zoom got disconnected, ma'am. So, hello.
Uh-huh.
Ma'am, can
Zoom get disconnected? Yeah, tell me.
There will be a 3-dot option in below the, maybe nearby the share option is there, no? By the share option, there will be what option will be there.
3-dot is there. Dot on the computer.
Ma'am, there will be a option like stop live stream.